Welcome to the Anatomy of Lungs video tutorial. In this video, I will be discussing about bronchopulmonary segments. At the end of this video, you should be able to know how to define these segments, their distribution in each lung, their structure, and what are all the contents seen in each segment and their clinical aspects. So let's start. Bronchopulmonary segments are called as well-defined sectors of lung. They can be defined as the structural and functional units of lung parenchyma, which are aerated by segmental or tertiary bronchi. Let's understand this diagrammatically. Here is one segmental bronchus, which is derived from a lobar bronchus. After successive orders of divisions, each segmental bronchus gives rise to terminal bronchioles, respiratory bronchioles, alveolar ducts, atria, alveolar sacs, and alveoli. Such a portion of bronchial tree formed from a single segmental bronchus enclosed within a tough fibroareolar tissue forms a well-defined independent portion of lung parenchyma. Such independent portions of lung parenchyma are called as bronchopulmonary segments. To define them precisely, they are portions of lung parenchyma aerated by single segmental bronchus, which means one segmental bronchus gives rise to one bronchopulmonary segment. In other words, the number of segmental bronchi will be equal to number of bronchopulmonary segments in a lung. So let's see the distribution of segmental bronchi in each lung to understand the distribution of bronchopulmonary segments. Here is the trachea bifurcating at T4 vertebral level into two principal bronchi, right and left. Right principal bronchus give rise to three lobar bronchi, upper, middle and lower, whereas the left principal bronchus give rise to two lobar bronchi, upper and lower. Let's see how many segmental bronchi are given off from each lobar bronchus. On the right side, the upper lobar bronchus give rise to three segmental bronchi, middle one two, the lower one five segmental bronchi, which makes 10 segmental bronchi in right lung. On the left side, the upper lobar bronchus give rise to 5 segmental bronchi. Initially, the upper lobar bronchus divides into ascending branch and descending branch. The ascending branch give rise to 3 segmental bronchi. The descending branch give rise to 2 segmental bronchi, which correspond with the segmental bronchi of middle lobe of right lung. Now, the left lower lobar bronchus give rise to 5 segmental bronchi. In total, there are 10 segmental bronchi in right left lung, which means there are 10 segmental bronchi in each lung, which corresponds with the number of bronchopulmonary segments. By understanding this, let's see the distribution of bronchopulmonary segments. Here are the two lungs showing their costal surfaces. Here is the right lung, here is the left lung. To understand how these bronchopulmonary segments are arranged in each lobe, let's demarcate the individual segments by drawing their borders. In the upper lobe of right lung, as there are three segmental bronchi, there are three bronchopulmonary segments arranged in this pattern. Middle lobe, two segmental bronchi give rise to two bronchopulmonary segments. In the lower lobe, there are five bronchopulmonary segments arranged in this way. So, this is the pattern of arrangement of bronchopulmonary segments in right lung. Each segment is separated from the adjacent one by tough fibroareolar tissue. And also they are separated by oblique fissure and horizontal fissure in right lung. Now let's see on the left lung. Upper lobe give rise to 5 bronchopulmonary segments. Here is the arrangement of these segments. Lower lobe, 5 more bronchopulmonary segments and their arrangement. In total, 10 bronchopulmonary segments are seen in each lung, and this is the way they are arranged. So what you need to understand here is each segment has its own area of distribution, its own territory, surrounded by a tough fibroareolar tissue so that they can be distinguishable clearly from the adjacent segments. Having understood about the number and the arrangement of bronchopulmonary segments, let's see how these segments are named. The segments are named according to their position in their lobes, in their corresponding lungs. Let's see the names of right lung bronchopulmonary segments. Here is the diagram of right lung showing its anterior border here. Here is the oblique fissure and here is the horizontal fissure. Now let's see the names of bronchopulmonary segments lobe wise. The upper lobe segments are called as apical segment, posterior segment, anterior segment. In the middle lobe, here is the lateral segment, medial segment. In the lower lobe, here is the apical or superior segment, anterior basal segment, lateral basal segment, posterior basal segment and medial basal segment. The medial basal segment is seen only on the mediastinal surface, just below the hilum. Let's see a video clip showing the arrangement of these bronchopulmonary segments in right lung. Upper lobe segments anterior, posterior, apical. Middle lobe, medial and lateral, lower lobe. Apical or superior, anterior basal, posterior basal, lateral basal and medial basal. Let's see the left lung bronchopulmonary segments and their names. Upper lobe segments are called as apical, posterior, anterior, similar to the right lung. But the upper lobe also give rise to superior lingular and inferior lingular segments in the left lung, which correspond with the medial lateral bronchopulmonary segments of middle lobe on the right lung. The lower lobe give rise to apical or superior segment here, anterior basal, lateral basal, posterior basal and medial basal. The medial basal segment is seen only on the mediastinal surface of the lung, just below the hilum. The number and position of these bronchopulmonary segments in both the lungs are constant. After seeing the distribution of these segments, let's see their structure. They are wedge-shaped segments having their base facing the surface of the lung covered by visceral pleura. The apex which faces towards the hilum and they are surrounded by intersegmental septa which are formed by fibroareolar tissue. These intersegmental septa, they separate the adjacent bronchopulmonary segments. Let's see what are all the contents seen in individual segments. The major content is being portion of bronchial tree called as segmental bronchial tree. From segmental bronchus till the formation of alveoli. And segmental branch of pulmonary artery and segmental branch of bronchial artery. So there are three major contents of bronchopulmonary segments. They are segmental bronchial tree, segmental branch of pulmonary artery and segmental branch of bronchial artery. Let's see the features of individual contents. The segmental bronchial tree starts from segmental bronchus. After 16 orders of dichotomous divisions, each segmental bronchus gives rise to bronchioles. Dichotomous divisions means each bronchus divides into only two bronchi. Such divisions are called dichotomous divisions. Now the bronchioles also undergo dichotomous divisions to give terminal bronchioles, which in turn give rise to respiratory bronchioles. The respiratory bronchioles undergo three successive orders of division to give rise to alveolar ducts. Similarly, alveolar ducts also undergo three orders of divisions to give atria. Each alveolar duct receives two atria. Each atrium receives two alveolar sacs. And each alveolar sac is surrounded by 30 alveoli. The alveoli are globular structures which are arranged as clusters of grapes. On a cross section, they give a honeycombed appearance. Individual alveoli, they are connected with the adjacent alveoli with large pores called pores of cone. From first order of respiratory bronchiole till the alveoli, the portion of the bronchial tree is known as respiratory unit or structurally pulmonary lobule, which participate in the exchange of gases, whereas the rest of the bronchial tree seen in a bronchopulmonary segment is known as conducting part of the bronchial tree, which participate only in the passage of the air. Let's see the features of other contents. Segmental branch of pulmonary artery. There are two pulmonary arteries, one for each lung. Right pulmonary artery here, left pulmonary artery. They are the branches of pulmonary trunk. They are depicted with blue color, which means they carry deoxygenated blood. The pulmonary trunk is the output of right ventricle of the heart. If we trace the pulmonary arteries, each artery accompanies the bronchial tree. The branches of the pulmonary artery also accompany the branches of or the divisions of bronchial tree. Till they reach the respiratory part of bronchial tree, where they form capillary plexuses around each alveolus and they participate in exchange of gases. From there, they drain into pulmonary veins. The branches of pulmonary artery are also anastomosed with branches of bronchial artery in a bronchopulmonary segment. Basically, the segmental branches of pulmonary artery, they supply respiratory part of bronchial tree. And throughout their course, they are related dorsolateral to the bronchial tree and its divisions. Let's see the features of segmental branch of bronchial artery in each segment. Bronchial arteries are the branches of descending thoracic aorta. There is one bronchial artery for right lung. There are two bronchial arteries for left lung. Occasionally, the right bronchial artery may arise from third right posterior intercostal artery instead of from descending thoracic aorta. These arteries, they closely run along the bronchial tree and they reach the corresponding bronchopulmonary segment, where they closely run along the respiratory part of bronchial tree, where they end by anastomosis with branches of pulmonary artery and they drain into pulmonary vein. Basically, they supply only the conducting part of the bronchial tree. Let's see the relation of these contents in corresponding bronchopulmonary segment. The main content being the bronchial tree, closely accompanied by dorsolaterally pulmonary artery branch and intimately related with branch of the bronchial artery. Pulmonary artery supplies the respiratory part, whereas bronchial artery supplies the conducting part. Finally, they drain into pulmonary vein tributaries, which are placed in intersegmental septa. They are not the contents of bronchopulmonary segments. The pulmonary vein tributaries are intersegmental in position, which means they drain adjacent multiple bronchopulmonary segments. In other words, each bronchopulmonary segment is drained by multiple intersegmental pulmonary vein tributaries. So the point here to be understood is the branches of pulmonary artery are segmental in distribution, whereas the tributaries of pulmonary vein are intersegmental in drainage, which makes bronchopulmonary segments, even though they are called as independent bronchopulmonary units, they should not be called as independent bronchovascular unit, because they are not drained by their own segmental pulmonary vein tributary. They are drained by intersegmental pulmonary vein tributaries. Let's revise the features of bronchopulmonary segments so far covered. They can be studied by the following headings: their definition, distribution, structure, and contents. To define them, they are well-defined sectors of lung. They act as structural and functional units of lung parenchyma, which are aerated by segmental bronchi. They are equally distributed in both the lungs. Their number and position is constant in both the lungs. The names of right and left lung bronchopulmonary segments are almost similar, except for upper lobe segments in the left lung, which are related to the lingula, are called as superior lingular and inferior lingular segments, which correspond with the lateral and medial segments of middle lobe of right lung. They are wedge-shaped structures surrounded by a tough fibroareolar tissue. They have three major contents: the segmental bronchial tree, segmental branches of pulmonary artery and bronchial artery, whereas the pulmonary vein tributaries are seen lying in the intersegmental plane. Now let's see the clinical aspects related to these segments. Lung abscess, the commonest inflammation seen in the lungs. The segments which most frequently seem to be affected by lung abscess are apical segment of lower lobe, posterior segment of upper lobe, as they are the most dependent segments in supine position, so that the purulent material can be collected in supine position in these dependent segments, forming abscess. The common cause for the abscess is aspiration pneumonia. which is usually a part of Mendelssohn's syndrome, in which the gastric juices are aspirated into the respiratory tract. They get settled in the bronchial tree in supine position in the most dependent bronchopulmonary segments. Naturally, the fibroareolar septa, which is enclosing individual segments, avoids the spread of inflammations to the adjacent segments, which acts like a natural barrier, so that the portion which is having a lung abscess can be removed by segmental resection by following the fibroareolar septa. The abscess may rupture peripherally into the pleural sac, where the pus can be collected into the pleural sac. That condition is known as pyothorax. A purulent material which is collected in alveolar sacs can be drained naturally without undergoing the segmental resection by following few natural or postural drainage methods, in which there are few postures are adopted depending on which segment of which lobe of which lung is affected, so that the purulent material can be moved or drained towards corresponding segmental bronchus, principal bronchus, and get settled at the bifurcation of the trachea naturally, where the mucous membrane can initiate cough reflex so that the purulent sputum can be coughed out. Tuberculosis of lung. The commonest lung segment affected by TB is posterior segment of upper lobe. The tuberculosis bacilli can break through the intersegmental septa and damage the lung tissue, can cause cavities in lungs. Lung carcinoma is most frequently seen in the anterior segment of upper lobe. Depending on the stage of the carcinoma, the segmental resection or segmentectomy can be done, even though the cancer cells can break through the intersegmental septa and show a widespread through even lymphatic channels and blood vascular system. So we have reached the end of this video after discussing the anatomical features of bronchopulmonary segments. Hoping this video has helped you in understanding and in remembering the features of bronchopulmonary segments. Thank you for your patient listening. Keep learning.